Hello everyone, so in this week's video we're going to be recreating the look from Panic at the Disco's Empress New Clothes music video. If you haven't seen that, I will link it down below and you can check it out and see what I'm creating. If you have seen that, we're going to start off by creating the horns, which are on this devil creature kind of thing that is featured in the music video. So I'm taking some foil, shaping that, and I'm using my face cast just to get a sort of good idea of how big they need to be to fit my forehead. If you don't have this, you can just measure it straight onto your forehead. Otherwise, do it onto a table or just onto a regular surface. Covering these foil pieces in latex and tissue just to create a good texture, make sure they have strength and give the paint something to hold onto when we paint these. I do about 2 to 3 layers. This will just make sure they're strong and that they will hold their shape. Once that's complete, we can begin working on our prosthetics on the chin and forehead. Taking some flour and latex mixed together to create this latex paste, as I've used in previous videos on my channel, and we're going to start sculpting out the chin piece. Reference photos are going to be a great help for a video like this, or a makeup transformation like this. He has an extended chin which comes to a point where it is curved at the top, and I'm just using normal latex to smooth out this paste and create a seamless edge so that when we apply it, it will be nice and smooth. Now that that's done, we can begin to work on our forehead piece. So just using the same liquid latex and flour method, and we're just going to start shaping out the forehead. Still using my reference photo, I'm just smoothing it all out with some regular latex and just making sure that it blends really well, that it doesn't go past my hairline or past where my eyebrows would be, as then that wouldn't work too well because I won't be able to see and it would be out of my face range. Then placing the horns in place and making sure it's all smooth and really nice and blended really well. Once that's done, I'm taking some more latex and flour, just with a bit more flour so it's thicker and clumpy, and we're going to be putting that around where the horns come through, just so it looks like they've broke straight through my skin on my forehead and it's all irritated and aggravated and stuff like that. Once the piece has dried, if the horns fall out, you can stick them back in, which is what I did. I use super glue, but you can use any glue or adhesive that you want, and that works best for you. Once that's done, we can begin to work on the little detailed pieces that Brendan has on his chin, his forehead and his chest. So I'm going to be using string dipped in liquid latex and then cover that in tissue and latex to hold it in place, and that will create these little spiral details which he has on his prosthetic pieces, on his chest, on his forehead, on the sides of his face and things like that. This is a great way to create details like this. It's the best one that I've found works, and yeah, so now that that's done, I've powdered it all just once, just in case anything does start to flap or anything, and then we're going to paint it all with our base colour of grey. Once that's done, we can then begin to paint the broken through parts on her forehead an even darker grey. Highlight, and is it low light, is that what you call it, on the detail pieces on our face and our prosthetic chin and forehead to make them stand out more, and then paint the horns completely black so that they just stick out the most from the prosthetic. Still highlighting and low lighting, and then powdering it all and removing the pieces, making sure to do this slowly so all the edges are nice and smooth. Once that's done, I have quiffed my hair, which is very unlikely anymore because I have curly hair now, but just look how long my hair is. So we're going to be applying the pieces, just putting latex down on my chin, letting that dry, then applying latex onto the back of the prosthetic, sticking it down, holding it in place, making sure that's fitted right, and then blending down the tabs and edges, pulling them tight and sticking them down. This will make a seamless, nice, smooth blend between the skin and the prosthetic. You can add tissue, which is what I have done on the underneath part, and little bits which won't stick down too well. This will just help blend the edges also. Once that's complete, let it dry and we are going to move on to our forehead piece. So covering your eyebrows and baby hairs, because we do not want to rip out our baby hairs or our eyebrows. We want to keep them all in place. We don't want the pain of ripping out the latex from them because it hurts. If you do get latex in them, you can put conditioner in your hair and it will break up the latex, because that's just how it works. Applying this prosthetic the same as the other prosthetic on our chin, but I'm putting string around it just to hold it whilst it dries, and I am going to move on to my ears. I made these earpieces off camera, but if you want to see a more in-depth tutorial on how I did that, I can do that, and I can show you how to cast ears and things like that. Sticking that down and then just blending out the edges with some latex again. Now this is complete, we can work on the paint job. So to begin with, I'm painting all of my neck, chest and skin on show on my face and arms with a black wash, and then getting darker in certain areas like around my eyes on the prosthetics, and then we're going to begin highlighting. So I've added a lot of white, and this made my face grey because I thought, oh, it looks grey, that's how it needs to be. But then when I looked at myself, I realised that is not what I wanted it to be and started adding darker pieces again. I've painted both of my ears black just as their base coat also, which I will highlight and make them look nicer as I continue this tutorial. So I added a highlight on my cheekbones and on my nose because I want my nose to be slim and slender and come to a point to change the shape. Also, I wanted to make my face look slimmer, so I contoured with black and white on this grey so that my cheeks look more in and that my cheekbones stick out more. And then I've just contoured my jawline also, because Brendan has quite a slim face and I haven't quite achieved that look, sadly. Once that's done, I've gone in with a black and made sure it was all completely dark on my neck and chest and arms, then highlighted on my ears and began to paint on the details on my chest. Where I use string on my prosthetic, I've painted on my chest, putting white and then dark above and below it, and here we go.
Welcome to the end of eras, ashes melted back to life.
Thank you for watching this week's video, guys. If you like this video, please like, share, subscribe, do all of that stuff, and I will see you next week for a new tutorial. Let me know in the comments what you think and what you want to see, and any questions, queries or concerns, just let me know. Follow all my links in the description for my social medias where I'll post extras. Goodbye.